I forget how. I lose count after I get to 20 because we run out of fingers and toes. Anyway, are we live streaming yet?
Yes.
Oh wow, that's a shame. Anyway, so people that watch me on Facebook know who I am. So anyway, this group we're going to do several pieces. Most of them are on the short side, although one of them is a little bit longer. We're going to start with a piece by James Barnes, who has been band director at the University of Kansas for many years, and he's also a tuba player. And I think all the original compositions on this program were composed by tuba players, and I think all of the arrangements, I would have to double check, were done by tuba players. So this is pretty much produced by tuba players, for tuba players. We're delighted to share it with you. So we're going to begin now with Fanfare by James Woodward. Includes a trio that is slightly separated from the group, Fernando, Zuniga, Jonathan Sandoval, and Derek Cunningham, which function as sort of three soloists in addition to the beautiful arrangement, Ave Maria, Franz Biebl. Thank you. Kenyon Wilson, who is the Tuba Euphonium professor at the University of Tennessee, Chattanooga. I told you, everything's by a tuba player. So it's a really neat piece, Tuba Quartet No. 1, Kenyon Wilson. Welcome Derek Cunningham to the stand.
Thank you.
Don't get up and go too far. We'll be doing a little bit of set changing.
One fourth of a song?
new quartet. All right, so welcome Fernando to the stage.
Thank you.
applause for these folks here. You guys have gone an hour and 15 minutes for what, about 8 or 9 weeks? So they've really accomplished a lot, I think, for being this early in the semester, this early in the year. And I appreciate Gary and Fernando for what they do. While we're setting up and between the pieces, we're going to have a group called Euphoric. It's been really terrific, and I don't usually brag on incoming classes and things. We really had a terrific group of freshmen, transfers, and graduate students come in this year. And this is going to include, this group is going to include three of those people, Travis Pratt from Biloxi, Dave McAllister from Ellisville, Cody Sully from Pensacola, Christopher Nix from Pascagoula. And I lied about everything being written by a tuba player. The piece they're going to play is written by James Woodward. James played the euphonium, so close enough, I guess. So these guys are gonna break down, and then we're gonna hear Euphoric, and then the ensemble. Thank you. two movements of it. I don't think I did the whole thing. I decided to do the whole thing. After looking at it this summer, this is one of the longest, one of the most challenging, I think one of the most interesting pieces for Tuba Euphonium Ensemble. It was written in 1994, I believe, by Michael Forbes. Michael is a freelance tubist in the Madison, Wisconsin area, very prolific composer. If you are a tuba player, tuba fan, you may have heard of the Son of Roche Quartet. Mike is a founding member of that group and writes many of the arrangements for it and compositions for it. So very prolific in that regard. This is an early work. It was actually premiered, at least to the best of my knowledge, it was premiered in 1995, maybe 96. It was premiered at the University of Wisconsin. I know this because I played principal tuba in the group that premiered it. So anyway, while we're setting up and while just to rest our chops a little bit because this will tax them, just a few notes from the composer. First of all, this is a piece in three movements, a symphony for 12-part Tuba Euphonium Ensemble. It's a three-movement work exploring different levels of thickness found in a Tuba Euphonium Ensemble. The contrasts involve differences in orchestration, numbers of players, harmonic filterings, dynamics, tempi, meter, and the list goes on. Practically every element of organized sound has been utilized for textural juxtaposition. That is true. The first movement is called Transparent. It explores pentatonic harmonies of which relatively thin chordal and quintal elements are derived with intense yet crisp multimeter pocket. Translucent, the second movement, becomes mistier immediately with its diatonic character and slower, more sustained quality. Modal counterpoint is also introduced to darken the texture, yet always preventing bent or refracted rays of light to squeeze through. The last movement, Opaque, opens with a recapitulation of the previous harmonic textures and inevitably lands flat on its own characteristic texture and chromatic cluster of all 12 notes. You'll know it when you hear it. Consequently, the texture opens harmonically, allowing for some comprehension of Tuba Euphonium material, but stays opaque rhythmically with its endless stream of eight notes. Finally, the movement remembers the various themes from previous movements before driving home its own theme, followed by a rhythmic, bombastic, don't say I didn't warn you, finale. So please enjoy Textures by Michael Fu. This thing is smaller every time I get it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mozart most people haven't heard of much. In German, it's Schicksalsgruber. Someone can correct me on that later. Translates into the Impresario. So we're going to close with this overture. Thank you all very much for coming. We've enjoyed having you. Appreciate your support of the group. Let's listen to Mozart. Thank you.